when it's coming out. Of course. Where's Timmy? You and Tommy go. Okay. So you forfeit? Alright. So this is Grands then? If you guys can hold up. Hold up while I get the stream set up. So, Tommy, are you in player one right now? Alright. Alright, one moment. All right, you guys are good to go.
All right, here we go. Tommy and Justice, Grand Finals.
Grand Finals! We're going to Tommy's favorite stage, Battlefield.
I know Justice likes the stage, too.
It's true.
They probably, I'm sure they agreed on it. I don't think they struck.
Yeah, Justice going back to the character we all love him for, Ike. For some reason, I just really like the fact that a dude named Justice plays Ike. It feels fitting to me somehow. Doesn't it?
He fights for his friends.
Right. It feels right. It feels right. I like it. I like his Pit too.
Yeah.
Pit and Ike are his mains. He played them in Brawl. So he's carried them over to Smash 4.
Did he,
A lot of people were surprised when Pit came out last week. He was going to play someone other than Ike.
Yeah.
So I asked him about it. Yeah.
He beat me with it earlier today.
Yeah. You actually forced it out.
No. What happened there?
I think Justice decided he wasn't going to be able to recover, and he side beat off the side like a Falco or something.
Really?
Yeah.
Wow. Interesting.
Oh, you know what? I will update this for you guys so that you know on what end of Grand Finals both players are coming in on. Tommy's made it in through the loser's end. And in turn, Justice, therefore, is on the winner's end.
And Tommy taking a big lead here so far.
Tommy actually put in losers by his brother because of some oddball seating that happened after Swiss today. And his brother went all the way to winner's finals and lost to Justice there. And then when Tommy finally caught up to him in loser's finals, they just let Tommy have the win.
There's a forward tilt and then up air by Sheik, almost taking Justice off the top. Oh, wow.
Great DI. Great DI, and Ike, being a very heavy character, was able to survive that.
Justice is really good at spacing his short hop aerials, but of course, so is Tommy.
Yeah, short hop aerials are like Sheik's thing as much as anyone else. Oh, wow, and runs into a vanish.
Yeah, he just drops down and upbees and uses that first jump from the upbee to go right on the very long ledge.
So Tommy goes up a game, looking in a favorable place to try to get that bracket reset. Let's see if Tommy, like Churro, manages to pull out this pit.
Let's take a look.
Palutena! Oh man. I wanted a Palutena for some reason. Palutena!
I'd love to see more Palutena.
I wish Palutena was better. I'd play her.
She's okay.
She's so pretty. She has some of the best hair in this game.
I got a Palutena amiibo. It's awesome.
Oh, I'm still waiting for mine to arrive. I ordered it. It's on the way in the mail.
Nice. Yeah, I ordered a Palutena and a Mennonite.
Cool.
Super cool.
Cool, cool. Cool, cool, cool. I'm like Abed. Community. Anyways. Palutena's hair is pretty.
Yep. She's a pretty lady.
She's a goddess. She's a goddess. Yes, Final Destination.
Make her, one of your tails.
She's sort of a candidate. I feel like the Ninetales doesn't even matter because I never played anyone other than Rosalina. Anyways, enough about Palutena and how pretty she is. We are on Final Destination, but this is not the final game of this set.
This is the second destination out of potentially 10 destinations.
Right? That doesn't mean this is the last time at this destination. This is even the potentially the final destination. Look at that pretty moon. Oh god, it just flew by.
Everything's so pretty.
I have...
Sheik is pretty.
Yeah, right? I'm in like a... I know Pitt's pretty.
Pitt's a pretty boy.
I guess so. I'll go for it.
He's maybe not pretty, but he's a pretty boy.
Yeah. I can get behind that, I guess. I mean, his features aren't like, you know, there's nothing unappealing about them.
No, not. Oh, wow. Trying to get that pivot side B.
I was gonna see how long we could go without actually talking about the game.
I thought we might as well say something about it.
Yeah, there you go. You're good. It was good. It was a good moment, too. Justice really likes, with his pit, he really likes to try to mix up that upper dash arm because it can really catch people off guard at the right moment.
Oh wow, great down smash.
Yep, picks up the roll read.
His down smash and his forward smash seem to have so much range on him.
Yeah, Pit is a very disjoint character. Unlike, for some reason you don't think he is because, you know, he holds that sword in the middle, or he holds the two swords in the middle as a bow. They don't look like they stick out very far, but then somehow they do. A lot of his aerials have more disjoint than you'd think they do too. Good landing, but nope, not really.
Nope.
Even
Tommy
even
makes
game.
Good use of his forward smash, even though that's not particularly a more common move by Sheik. But he always makes good use of the ledge there.
Yep.
Wow, this is just really back and forth.
For real. Needles going
and
to
now,
the needle camp.
Now we're playing the space game.
Oh, we've been in space the whole time with that pulsating nebula.
That's so pretty.
It's back to the pretty moon. That flew by.
There it goes.
one whole backdrop cycle of the animation.
Who's going to be next to fly by? Is Pit going to fly by or is Sheik going to fly by?
Let's hope that with that sun getting so close, Kid Icarus doesn't fly too close to it.
This time I'm trying to read that air dodge again with the up smash.
Yep.
But Justice knows, and he floats out.
Yep, Justice excels a lot in the mind game of returning to the stage, I feel like. Especially from above. He's not one to fall for those kinds of traps very easily. That's why I was a little surprised that forward smash got him. So, we're looking at percents now where a forward throw is probably going to be a kill if Justice can get it.
Yeah, Tommy's got to be really careful next to the ledge there.
Yeah, with his back to it, too. That's the interesting thing.
Oh, forward tilt out there. That's going to do it. Yeah, just the right percent. That'll take it out.
Yep, it did. Tommy now up two games on Justice. See if I can, like I said, sorry, I apologize again. Stuff is hard to edit today. There we go, though.
Tommy just one match away, or one game away from a bracket reset here.
Yeah, but a 3-0 bracket reset, which is pretty stylish.
Yeah, that was a really close game, though.
It's pretty pretty.
I wonder if Justice will stay as Pit or go back to his Ike.
I feel like his...
Yeah, we could see a Sheik Ditto.
I feel like his Pit worked out for him a little better. The Ike felt kind of taken advantage of. You could almost feel the tier distance, the tier difference there.
Yeah, Sheik was just man enough to get right into Ike's face.
Robear,
hunt him down.
Would you be a perfect gentleman and bring me that chair for Churro to sit on?
Throw it. Oh, wow. Tommy just not letting up here.
All right, never mind. No chair for Churro. Yeah, he isn't.
Huh?
superhero plot.
Oh, yeah. Ooh, wow. Tommy's got to be careful with the ledge there. Justice is great. so good at punishing recoveries onto the ledge and getting that the re-grab.
And that, it was a very pretty punish on the bouncing fish. You know, he knew it was coming, so he just sort of like, he didn't even fret about it. He just sort of casually walked back, turned around, and forward smashed. All right. We're getting that vanish to the ledge. Interesting Sheik-type maneuver. So I didn't realize this, but, you know, Sheik's vanish has always been, the concept has been that sort of like, you know, ninja, you throw a smoke ball down on the ground and it blows up, but like Sheik's has always been a grenade, and that's why it's an explosion that hurts people in all the, in every game since Melee. And so like, in this game, when they updated her moveset to not have the chain anymore, they decided they'd give her that grenade as an actual attack in addition to just throwing it on the ground.
Yeah. So, she's a, yeah, she's got grenades, she's part snake now.
Yeah, part snake. No snake anymore, but we do have these grenades still flying around. Not quite as menacing as they used to be, but the vanish one is god menacing. It makes you, like, scared to try to go for any edgeguard on Sheik. It almost makes it a bad idea to try to edgeguard Sheik.
Yeah, I've learned that the hard way.
Wow, picking up another up air kill on Justice. Justice is struggling.
Yeah, I think that was another forward tilt up air.
This is actually the first time these players are playing in this bracket. Justice was not the person who put Tommy in losers, as I said earlier. It was Timmy who did that. And Justice pulled out a 3-1 win on Timmy in winner's finals, so... We're seeing
That's impressive.
A difference between the caliber, or at least the ability to go against Justice, between the two Smash Twins right now.
So there's Justice's first kill on Tommy this game.
Yep, up at dash.
But that just resets her rage and lets her get some more combos with her fair there.
Yep.
Really building up that percent. Over 100 on Justice's pit.
Oh, interesting but very well done follow-up. Run back in and go back for another grab. It worked out. Oh,
wow.
That dare
nice
was a
dare.
Crazy mix-up.
Yeah, that slight sort of little hop in the air it gives you.
It threw off
just enough.
Yeah, it threw off the shielding that Justice was expecting. He was ready to drop his shield after a fair and then go for some sort of punish on that. He dropped his shield early. No hit. There was no hit stun. Just got dared. Ooh. There we go. Forward throw.
Oh, is that going to do it? Oh, my goodness.
Not
quite. He's trying to snipe him with some arrows after that. Did some good air dodges by Tommy. Not letting him do that.
Oh, upper dash arm. A little bit of a mistake. Tommy was not going in at that moment. That was a really well-placed up beat.
Yeah, it's smart by Tommy to try and punish that because there's no hitbox on it. Oh, be careful, Tommy. Really good evasion there.
Yeah, vanish onto the platform. Oh, but that's it.
Forward smash.
That's it. Justice, finding his game a little bit, picks up a win on Tommy. He's not going to let this be a 3-0 bracket reset, even if it ends up being a bracket reset.
I want my soda.
I don't think we're going to have time for our crew stuff today, sadly.
We were planning on crew stuff?
We were going to try to do a crew battle like we've done before.
That would be fun, but yeah, I think we're about out of time here.
Yep, we only got half an hour left, and we still got a lot of games in this particular set, potentially, so... Alright, we're getting the run back. Justice wanted to take it back to Smashville, which isn't honestly the worst idea. Smashville being such a great stage for Sheik. Wow, and we got a little bit of the quote chain grab unquote of Sheik in this game. Got one chain of it, one link of the chain, but didn't go further.
I thought she didn't have a chain yet.
I
thought she got a grenade instead.
Nope. Oh, haha. Yeah. No character has a true train grab in this game. However, a number of characters have true combos that lead into further grabs.
Yeah.
that they have a grab that leads into a, that True Combos into a move that True Combos back into a grab. And Sheik is one of them at percents below 70 or so. A down throw can True Combo into a falling up air. And all the hits of up air, bar the last hit, have a small amount of downward knockback on them just to keep the combo, to keep the drill on you.
Yeah, you can do something similar.
That bouncing
wow.
fish.
Great bouncing
that
fish.
Bouncing
under
fish.
The stage.
Yeah, wow.
Yeah, a lot of multi-hit moves have similar properties. If you fastball when your opponent is caught in it and land on the
stage,
you can really drag people down with you.
Yep. So that's
Meta Knight has something very similar
with his back air.
Yeah.
Rosalina has it kind of with her fair. It only really works upon landing, unlike a lot of these other characters who can sort of drop out of it as they go. Fox is very famous for his forward air version of this.
Yeah,
so yeah, it's something a lot of characters can do, and Sheik's sets up a chain grab, because since that up air is a true combo at low percents out of her down throw, it can pull them right back down into a true combo grab. It's fun to see. When you see it, it's cool because it's, you know, a little bit more tech-heavy move that requires a lot more practice than just a fair string.
Yeah, yeah, definitely looks hard to do. Fortunately, Mario's down air doesn't quite work.
Dude, can I just say it? Right, actually, you'll see it. When, there was a moment you did something crazy with Mario, and I was like, I was like flipping out. That was a very nice uppercut arm. Yeah. You did a back air. You did like four back airs, and it was exactly like a Sheik fair string. I was like, damn! Right. But Justice had a huge disadvantage here, down by about 90%. That wasn't enough to kill because there's no rage on Sheik. But that was a danger. That was a danger moment.
Yeah, Pitt's at a really high percent here, but at this percent, Sheik's throws don't really combo into anything unless your opponent air dodges or you can catch their landing.
Yep. They don't combo anything, but they do put you in an advantage state.
Yeah.
So not bad. They're just like, once they happen, Justice still has the chance to live with the right mix-ups and reads. Good dash attack. Catches the little bit of aerial movement Tommy had just started there. Pitt's dash attack is very good. He doesn't move too far forward with it, so he doesn't like end directly in the opponent's face afterwards. So it's a little bit harder to punish than a regular dash attack, and it's also very disjointy.
Yeah, using that sword lets him beat out a lot of other attacks. Oh wow!
What?
Nice ledge truck.
That comeback was sick by Justice.
That was incredible. Just the quick runoff, and what you do is you roll the control stick all the way halfway around,
yep,
back towards the stage, and that lets you grab the ledge right away. But it's hard to do. Your timing has to be
pretty
pinpoint.
Hard to do. And actually, it gets harder to do the more fast falling your character is. It should be obvious, I guess, but yep. Sets up a lot of true combo back airs for a lot of characters, and obviously Pit is one of them. And in the, even though Pit did have all that damage, in the famous words of Kelly Clarkson, what doesn't kill you does make you stronger.
Yeah, it really does.
So that back air was primed and ready to kill. But game 5 of the first set of Grand Finals, Tommy wins this. Justice has to do all his work all over again to try to defend his place. If Justice takes this, then this is the end of the tournament today.
Yep, but Justice's Pit has really been working out for him in this matchup so far.
Yep. Pit seems to be his better anti-Sheik character. I'm pretty sure that loss he took game 1 was the first time I've ever seen his Ike get 2 stocks. Unless, like, I'm forgetting a shuffle match against the Mewtwo King or something. Definitely the first time I've ever seen it happen here at Salem. Oh, wow.
Literally air dodging the drill from Sheik.
Yeah. These forward tilts really set up up airs. I don't see a lot of other Sheiks do that with their forward tilt, but Tommy's getting a lot of mileage out of it.
Yeah, it's definitely a true combo at a little bit lower percents. That's why I think town and city stages like that are really scary. A lot of stages are scary with Sheik, but
yeah. Well, I always think of Sheik as sort of a character that really carries you horizontally, and that's why I always think this is actually one of the scariest Sheik stages. Anytime Sheik happens to carry you the same direction as the platform, it's just like that much more of a string she gets.
Yeah, I definitely try to avoid taking Sheik to the stage.
Back air? It was hard to tell whose back air that was for a second, because yeah. I felt like both of them were ready to throw one out. Oh, pop bouncing fishes the balloon.
And then another back air, but the weak hit.
We pop time. Those. Hashtag we pop those. Oh, you saw that upper dash arm coming out for just a sec there.
Yeah, the super armor not quite coming out fast enough there.
Yep.
Wow, a good offstage snipe. Tommy retreating to the safety of the platform off the stage there.
Yep.
But now he's got the stage.
Forward throw, that's it.
That's it, that is the first stock.
Hits forward throw, probably the best forward throw in the game. Unless Dark Pit's is a little better, which I think it is.
Really?
Yeah, Dark Pit, Pit have a sort of Dr. Mario kind of thing going on, where like, Dark Pit hits a little harder than Pit in almost every aspect, but his tools are worse overall.
Really?
Yeah. I mean, it's a lot less extreme though. But yeah, best forward throw in the game. Most characters are relying on really good back throws or up throws for their kill throws. So it's interesting that what this character has a great forward throw. It puts him in an interesting position when he dashes you at the edge. A lot of characters try to set up their kill throws, you know, with their backs to the edge. He gets his on approach at the edge.
Yeah, a lot of characters, you gotta roll to the ledge or try and get a pivot grab, but Pit can safely get grabs from his stage control position.
Yeah.
Another character that has a pretty good forward throw is Peach.
That's true.
I think her back throw is actually stronger in this game.
Yep. She does have a forward throw that kills a little earlier than most, though. That back throw to arrow just looks so cool when he does it. Like that? Like, isn't that cool? That looks like an action sequence. So we got that rare Sheik pummel. That's one of the few things Sheik doesn't have good data on. Her pummel is so slow. Alright, well, Justice taking a 50-ish percent lead in this final game before Tommy was able to finish the stock off. Let's see what happens next.
Back to the arrow.
Yep. It looks so cool. I almost just want to play Pit to do that to people. Looks like something like I don't know, just any sort of action movie archer does. Like in Avengers or in Lord of the Rings or something. Just like chucks them, pulls out a bow and shoots it at them as they're flying still.
Totally unrealistic mid-action 360 spins.
Yeah. It's crazy. Oh, needle the bouncing fish.
Oh, wow, super armor
yeah.
Fish.
Yeah.
And this is getting Tommy really catching up here now.
Yeah, this is getting close. Oh, these needles. He hasn't been needling a lot of Sheik, and needles are one of Sheik's kind of safest tools in a lot of ways. Especially since the airborne needles do set up bouncing fish kills safely.
Yeah. Does it only work when they're fully charged?
You know, it just sort of works whenever, as long as you're in the right range, I think. I mean, I don't think it works with I don't know. You know what? I'm not going to pretend I know.
We don't play Sheik.
Yep.
But
there it is, the forward throw.
That's going to be it. No bracket reset. Justice
came very close, though.
Again.
Let me get this edited before it gets to the point where it would be cut. There we go.